There are over 100 elements on the periodic table, and one of them stands out of all. It's used in electronics, architecture, jewelry. But what is it about gold that makes it so precious? On Monday, August 24th, 2015, the Dow Jones Industrial Average plummeted nearly 1,100 points, the biggest decline on record in a single trading day. Nearly every time something like this happens, there's someone coming out of the woodwork saying that gold is a better investment. But gold is really just a pretty rock. How did it become so valuable? Most of the gold on Earth comes from meteorites that smacked down onto the surface 200 million years after the Earth formed, and humans have been fascinated with it for millennia. I mean, gold has been used as currency throughout advanced civilization. The earliest use of gold coins dates back to ancient Egypt around 500 BCE. Before coins, there was a system of values based on weights of gold, silver, and copper. Romans, Egyptians, and ancient Indians all used gold as a form of currency. And as modern nations started to adopt paper currency, though, they used gold as a backing for its value. But we've moved away from that. While we don't use it to back our currency anymore, gold is still highly valued. Last I checked, it was about $1,148 per ounce, and it's rarer than you think. The entirety of a year's worth of global gold production can fit inside of your living room. A large amount of gold and silver was just found in reservoirs underneath volcanoes in New Zealand. If mined, it could be worth billions for years to come. So why does this space rock mean so much to us, and how did it become used as currency? Well, there's several theories, and it's got a lot to do with chemistry. Elements like gases and liquids make zero sense in terms of currency. Way too hard to carry around. Alkaline metals and earths, well, try dropping magnesium in water and see what happens. Not so good for our currency. Lead and copper were tried as coinage in some places like ancient China, but they quickly corroded. And lead, well, lead's always been a little toxic, so that's never good. And other precious metals, some are too rare to be of any practical currency. And while some are too difficult to turn into anything, I mean, it takes over 3,000 degrees to melt platinum. So that brings us back to silver and gold. Silver makes for a great currency, durable and rare enough to be desired. And gold, well, it's pretty inert. It's the least reactive of any metal, so it won't corrode when exposed to things like water or oxygen. It won't ever rust or tarnish. So if you made a golden statue and left it sitting in a public square for 1,000 years, it would roughly look the same, where a copper statue would turn green in only a few years. And speaking of a statue, that's another plus in the gold column. It's so easy to manipulate and make stuff out of, whether that's art, jewelry, or coins. And that brings me back to another point. Gold beats out all other metals, even silver, in value because it's pretty. I mean, its chemical symbol is Au from the Latinum aurum, meaning shining dawn. So it lasts for a while, and it's easy to manipulate, and it's pretty. That would be used on pretty much everything aesthetic, like buildings, paintings, sculptures, jewelry. And now you have one of the most precious things to humanity. So why is it valuable? Because it's rare and pretty. The end. So while we do love our precious gold, other metals are just as, if not more, valuable for use in things like electronics. But there's a bit of a problem. We might be running out. Where should we turn? To space, of course. Trace explores whether we should mine an asteroid for platinum in this great video right here.
Once asteroids are located, scientists use ground-based infrared telescopes and spectrometers to see which minerals exist in its structure. Different minerals absorb light at different wavelengths.
Thanks for watching DNews. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you liked this episode. Now tell us, what is your most precious item? You can tell us down in the comments below, or you can tell us over on our Facebook page, or we're on Twitter at DNews. Thanks for watching.